everyone, it's Jackson from Talos. Today we're going to be talking about how you can listen to text-to-speech on your Windows computer. Now a while back I made a Mac version of this video and I promised I would make a Windows version. This is going to be that video. But before you continue, I do suggest you go and watch that old video because it's going to be really helpful explaining why text-to-speech is useful and what you can use it for. But in this video, we're going to be talking about a specific program called Balabolka. Now I know that sounds like a weird name, and sometimes people are turned off because the program looks a little bit weird, but it's a really, really powerful program and I highly suggest you continue watching this video. We're going to jump right in. So in this video what we're going to be going over is downloading Balabolka, the basic functions of the program, the global shortcuts which are really important to understand, and then lastly, the clipboard reader, which is also very powerful. I'm going to leave a table of contents in the YouTube description so that you can actually find the specific parts of the video and then click on the links to them. So the first thing you're going to need to do is actually download Balabolka itself. So I'm going to have you go to whatever browser you want. I'm going to use Google Chrome. And you're going to just type in Balabolka. I'm also going to leave a link in the description to the actual website. So go and click on this link, Balabolka cross plus A. And you're going to see this button, download Balabolka. I just want to let you know, we don't take any legal responsibility for anything you do on your computer. All right, so download Balabolka, and I'm going to probably skip ahead until it's actually finished. All right, so you just click over here on the zip file, and it'll open up. Click on the button, mark setup. Now, you may get some notifications saying you can't search this file right now, just run it. And it'll also give you another notification saying, do you want to allow this app from an unknown publisher to make changes on your device? I'm going to hit yes. And then you have a selection of languages. I'm going to choose English and hit next. Then you have this Balabolka installation. This is a setup. I'm going to hit next. You can put it wherever you want and then continue. And I'm going to check the box pinned to taskbar. You can also check the box that creates a desktop item, which is already checked. And it's going to install. Alright, so we just finished the installation, so I'm going to leave it checked to launch Balabolka now because I want to show you what it looks like. Alright, so this is the Balabolka interface. It'll look something like this. So you have the option to just type text into it, and you can listen to that.
Jackson is cool.
And you'll notice it's highlighting the words, which is really helpful. You can actually see what it's reading. You have the option to change the speed, which I leave at 10.
Jackson is cool.
And I recommend that you start at 0, but you move it up slowly, like maybe once a week, and by no time, it'll be really fast. You also have the option to change the pitch and the volume, which I'll leave. And you can change the voice as well from all these different voices. You may only have 0 downloaded, and that's fine. Just leave it like that for now. I'm going to also go to the view and change the buttons. So I'm going to make sure that skip to previous paragraph, skip to next paragraph, and sentence, and all those things are checked right here. And I'm going to check the large buttons as well and hit OK. This allows us to have a few different options, and I'll demonstrate this by grabbing an article. So I have this article from the New York Times. I'm just going to select that, copy with Control C, and then paste with Control V. And I have the option now to play, which I can.
Washington Congressional
But
Republican.
I can also skip
the
forward
Senate
a sentence,
had one plan.
Back a
Washington
sentence,
Congre-
forward
the
a paragraph,
had one plan.
And back a paragraph.
Washington Congressional.
Which is pretty darn useful, and I find very helpful. So before I go any further, I really should make one key distinction for you. And that's the difference between a local and a global shortcut. So what's a local shortcut, first of all? A local shortcut is a shortcut that works in a specific program. For example, if I'm in Microsoft Word and I hit Control T, that will create a hanging indent, which is a special type of formatting. If I'm in Google Chrome, on the other hand, and I hit Control T, it will create a new tab. So it's the same keystroke, but it does two completely different things depending on what program you're in. But a global shortcut, on the other hand, is something that works in all programs, no matter what the program is. For example, if I hit Control C and I'm selecting text, whether I'm in Microsoft Word or Google Chrome, it will copy that text. So it doesn't matter what program I'm in, it works in all of them. So we're going to try to create a special global shortcut group for Balabolka. Let's jump in. So why would we want to set up global shortcuts in Balabolka? Well, let's say that I have an article in Balabolka, and I'm listening to it for school. And I also need to take notes. So I start listening to my document here.
Raiders at Tehran's Grand Bazaar have taken part in a big protest against rising prices and the plummeting.
And then I realize I need to pause it because I need to write notes. So I say, Raiders.
and then I keep going.
Value
and I
have of to Iran's hit play currency, again. The real.
And then I realize I need to pause it again, and I just have to keep scrolling back and forth and back and forth. And that's just kind of a pain, because I can't type and listen at the same time. How do we stop this problem? Well, if we have a global shortcut, even if we're in Google Chrome, we can hit a shortcut, and it will stop playing what's in Balabolka. So, for example, if I was typing here, and then I wanted Balabolka to play, I could hit a shortcut and keep typing, and Balabolka would be playing and pausing while I wanted it to without me having to press these buttons over here. I would just have to hit a shortcut on my keyboard. So let's jump right in. I'm going to show you how to set up these shortcuts. So I want you to imagine that K is the center key, right? Because if you're typing on the home row, then K will be where your middle finger is. K is going to be the pause play button. J is going to be the rewind, and L is going to be the fast forward. O is going to be your skip forward, and U is going to be your skip back. It kind of makes sense, right? M is going to be your start a new text thing. If you want to start listening to new text, M is going to be your button to do that. And I is going to be stop. So everything revolves around K, so you don't have to move your fingers too much, but also because it's a very, it just makes logical sense. So go to options in Balabolka, then hit settings. And you have a lot of different menus. The menu we care about is hotkeys, not shortcuts. Make sure you're not clicking on the shortcuts tab. That's a local shortcut setup. I want to use global hotkeys. So make sure you check use global hotkeys. There's a box right there. And then you have all these different options to set up your various hotkeys. First of all, you'll notice that the control and alt keys are checked in all of the shortcuts. And I'll explain that in just a second. But before I do that, I want to go down and check skip to next paragraph and skip to previous paragraph. Everything else is already pre-checked. So why is control and alt already checked? Well, we could just make read aloud the M key, right? However, that doesn't really make any sense. And the reason that doesn't make any sense is because you use M for other things than reading aloud. For example, if M was your shortcut key and not control alt M, then anytime you wanted to type the letter N, your computer would start playing Balabolka, which wouldn't make any sense. So instead, what we're doing is anytime we hit Control Alt M, we'll have Balabolka start reading. So we're going to change right here where it says F5. We're going to click that, and then we're going to just type in M and hit Enter, and that will change this to M. We're going to go to pause, and we're going to click on that, and we're going to hit K. So that's our main control button. We're going to go to stop, and we're going to make that I and hit enter. We're going to go to read selected text. That actually, you don't have to do anything. It doesn't really do anything. We're going to go to the one that says read clipboard aloud, which is F9, and we're going to make that C. I'll explain read clipboard aloud in just a second, but don't worry about that for now. Also, make sure that emulate control C before reading is pressed. Then go to skip to next sentence and hit L and hit enter. Skip to previous sentence, J, and hit enter. We're going to go to skip to next paragraph, and we're going to hit O and hit enter. We're going to skip to previous paragraph and hit U and hit enter. We're going to scroll down a little bit more, and that's it. So that's all we care about, and then you're going to hit OK, and you're done. Okay. So now let's see what's happening. Let's say that we're in this right here, and we want to play this, so we hit Command. We hit Control, Alt, and M.
Shops were shut and thousands of people took to the streets of the capital.
And we want to pause it. We hit Control, Alt, K, and it pauses it. So now, if we're in this window here, and we're typing, and we hit Enter, and then we want to play it, we hit Control, Alt, K.
Riot police later fired
two. And we can fast forward by hitting Control, Alt, L.
It was the biggest protest in Tehran. We can pause it again.
We can rewind by hitting Control, Alt, J.
Riot police later fired.
We can skip back a paragraph by hitting Control Alt U.
Shops were shut in thousands.
And we can skip forward a paragraph by hitting Control Alt O.
Riot police later.
And if we want to stop it completely, we hit Control Alt I. So you have all these great options now. You can control everything from your keyboard. Trust me, if you try this, it becomes significantly more efficient. So remember that last shortcut I told you was really important, but I didn't really explain? Well, I'm going to explain that one now. So it was Control, Alt, and C. So what does that do? What it does is it reads whatever text you selected. And I'll give a technical explanation of what exactly that means right after I show you how it works. So if I select this text and I hit Control, Alt, C.
With the title of Sense and Sensibility is connected one of those minor problems which delight
so
the
So it actually splitters. Reads no matter what I'm selecting. And I can use all of my same shortcuts. I can use Ctrl-Alt-K to pause it and play it.
Criticism.
I can skip forward with Ctrl-Alt-L. And I can also stop it by hitting Ctrl-Alt-I. And if I want to select something new and read it, I have to hit Ctrl-Alt-I first and then select it. But then I can read, say, this.
Mansfield Park. Our names.
So how is this actually doing this? Well, what it's doing is when I hit Ctrl-Alt-C, what it first does is it copies whatever text you want to read. So it essentially says this. We're going to hit Ctrl-C and copy it. And then we're going to read whatever's on the clipboard. What's the clipboard? Well, the clipboard is actually where you store copied information. So if you were to copy something on your computer, it stores it in a special little place. Imagine it's like a little document with whatever you've copied. And then your computer knows it can read that using Balabolka. So what it does is it says copy here and then read whatever is copied.
So that's all for this video. I hope it's been really helpful to you. Don't forget to like and subscribe and also to leave a comment below. See you all next time.